Mathematics is a branch which is closely associated with science, with which you can solve problems, etc. There are thousands of contradictions in the Bible. Hundreds deal with mathematics. I'll just touch on few of them. It's mentioned in Ezra chapter number 2, verse number 1, and Nehemiah chapter number 7, verse number 6, the context, that when the people returned from exile from Babylon, when King Nebuchadnezzar of Babylon, when he released the men from Israel, they came back from captivity, and the list of the people are given. The list is given in Ezra chapter number 2, verse number 2 to 63, and Nehemiah chapter number 7, verse number 7 up to 65. The list is given with the names as well as number of people released. In these 60 verses, there are no less than 18 times the name is exactly the same, but the number is different. There are no less than 18 contradictions in less than 60 verses of these two chapters. This is the list. I don't have time to run through the list. There are no less than 18 different contradictions in less than 60 verses. Further, it's mentioned in Ezra, chapter number 2, verse number 64, that the total congregation, if you add up, it comes to 42,360. And if you read in Nehemiah, chapter number 7, verse number 66, there also the total is the same, 42,360. But if you add up all these verses, which I had to do my homework, this is the list of Ezra, this is the list of Nehemiah. Ezra chapter number 2, Nehemiah chapter number 7. If you add up in Ezra chapter number 2, it doesn't come to 42,360, it comes to 29,818. And if you add up Nehemiah chapter number 7, even there it doesn't come to 42,360, it comes to 31,089. The author of the Bible, presumed to be Almighty God, does not know simple addition. If you give this problem even to a person who passed elementary school, he'll be able to get the right answer. If you add up all the 60 verses, it's so easy. Almighty God didn't know adding, knows billah, if we presume that this is the word of God. Further, if we read in Ezra chapter number 2, verse number 65, it says there were 200 singing men and women. Nehemiah chapter number 7, verse 67, there were 245 singing men and women. Were they 200 or were they 245 singing men and women? Context is the same, a mathematical contradiction. It's mentioned in the 2 Kings, chapter number 24, verse number 8, that Joachim was 18 years old when he began to reign Jerusalem, and he reigned for 3 months. 2 Chronicles, chapter number 36, verse number 9 says that Joachim was 8 years old when he began to reign, and he reigned for 3 months, 10 days. Was Joachim 18 years when he began to reign, or was he 8 years old? Did he reign for 3 months, or did he reign for 3 months, 10 days? Further, it's mentioned in the 1 Kings, chapter number 7, verse number 26, that in Solomon's temple, in his molten sea, he had 2,000 baths. In 2 Chronicles, chapter number 4, verse number 5, he had 3,000 baths. Did he have 2,000 baths, or did he have 3,000 baths? That I leave it upon Dr. William Campbell to decide which is correct. There is a clear-cut mathematical contradiction. It's mentioned in the 1 Kings, chapter number 15, verse number 33, that Baasha, he died in the 26th year of reign of Asa. And 2 Chronicles, chapter number 16, verse number 1 says that Baasha invaded Judah in the 36th year of the reign of Asa. How can Baasha invade 10 years after his death? It's unscientific. It's mentioned in the 2 Kings, chapter number 8, verse number 26. It says that Ahaziah, he was 22 years old when he began to reign. 2 Chronicles, chapter number 22, verse number 2 says that he was 42 years old when he began to reign. Was he 22 years old, or was he 42 years old? mathematical contradiction. Furthermore, in 2 Chronicles, chapter number 21, verse number 20, it says that Jehoram, the father of Ahaziah, he reigned at the age of 32 and he reigned for 8 years and he died at the age of 40. Immediately, Ahaziah became the next ruler at the age of 42. Father died at the age of 40. Immediately, son takes over, who's at the age of 42. How can a son be 2 years older than the father? Believe me, even in Hollywood film, you will not be able to produce it. In Hollywood film, you can produce a unicorn, which I mentioned in my talk, unicorn. You can have cockatrices, which the Bible speaks about, cockatrices and dragons and serpents. But in Hollywood, you cannot even show a son being 2 years older than the father. It cannot even be a miracle. Even in miracle, it's not possible. Impossible. In miracle, you can have a person being born of a virgin birth, but in miracle, you can't have a son being older than the father by 2 years. Further, if you read, it's mentioned in the Bible in 2 Samuel, chapter number 24, verse number 9, that the people that were involved in the battlefield, it gives a list of these people in 2 Samuel, chapter 24, verse number 9, and it says that people that took part, 800,000 of the men of Israel took part, and 500,000 of the men of Judah. Same, if you see other places, 1 Chronicles, chapter 21, verse number 5, it says that 1,100,000 people took part in the battlefield from the men of Israel, and 10,460 men took part of Judah. Was it 800,000 people who took part from the men of Israel, or was it 1,100,000? Was it 5 lakh people of Judah that took part, or 10,460? A clear-cut contradiction. Furthermore, it's mentioned in the Bible in 2 Samuel, chapter number 6, verse number 23, that Michal, the daughter of Saul, she had no sons. 2 Samuel, chapter 21, verse number 8, Michal, the daughter of Saul, had 5 sons. One place it says no children, no son, no daughter. Other place, 5 sons. Furthermore, if you read, it's mentioned in Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 1, verse number 16, it says about the genealogy of Jesus, peace be upon him, as well as Luke chapter number 3, verse number 23. And it says that Jesus' father, that Joseph, his father was Jacob, in Matthew chapter 1, verse 16. And Luke chapter 3, verse number 23, Jesus' father Joseph, his father was Heli. Did Jesus' father Joseph had 2 fathers? What do you call a person who has got 2 fathers? Or was it Heli or was it Jacob?
Thank you, Dr. Nayak. Thank you very much.